Hi, I'm Nina from Pessler, and today I'll be showing you how to monitor your bandwidth using SNMP and WMI. There are two other possibilities to monitor your bandwidth, which include packet sniffer and the various X flows, which for us include IPFIX, NetFlow, SFlow, and JFlow. The advantages of WMI and SNMP is that they're relatively little or have relatively little impact on your CPU load, don't take much to install, and they can also monitor other aspects of your network. Okay, so now let's start by adding the WMI sensor. We do this by clicking Add Sensor, and we can search here Windows WMI, and then we type network card, and there it is. So we only have one port, which we will select, of course, and create the sensor. While it's adding the sensor, it's important to know that the WMI sensor is not exclusively a WMI sensor, because it used the performance counters first before resorting back to WMI. So now let's refresh this one. Okay, now that it went into a green state, we can see a few of the metrics the sensor is monitoring, which includes the discards, the errors, the non-unicast, packets received and sent, and of course the total traffic in and out. Another option we have with PRTG is to use SNMP. We prefer this method because it's a bit more lightweight. So let's switch to another device that's SNMP enabled and add an SNMP sensor. Like before, we can filter for it. And here we have the SNMP traffic sensor. We can now see that there's a bunch of ports. You can select as many as you want. If you don't select any at all, the sensor will just give you the total traffic in and out. So I'll just select some random ones. You also see you have the options to add additional channels. I'll leave it with the default state. And let's add the sensor. As before, we will now refresh to get our data. Okay, now that it turned green, let's have a look at one of the ports. And as you can see, it gives you the traffic in and out. But one of the advantages of SNMP is that we have some additional options. So now let's go back to our device, to the device settings. And let's look for the SNMP compatibility settings. Here we go. So what do we have here? First of all, you can choose the delay you want. The default is 0. You also can choose the option what PRTG should do in case one of the requests failed. It can either retry or not retry. An important one is the overflow value, which we have here. With the overflow value, it is the problem that the counter is usually only 32-bit long. So it's important to set what you want to do in case of an overflow. Because sometimes there's also 64-bit counters. Then the request mode is also very important because some older devices are not able to do the multi-get. So for older devices, it would be recommendable to use the single get. However, if you have a newer device, you can stay with the default, the multi-get. And then the next three metrics are important in case of, for example, a restart of your switch or router. Because in SNMP, the port numbers are not static or not assigned to a specific port. So let's say you were monitoring port 8, your switch restarts, and now you might see that the port is behaving differently. This doesn't mean that your port is behaving differently, but just that the port number has been reassigned. So with the port name template, you can choose the port name update and port name identification that is most stable for your device. to ensure that you always stay or monitor the same port. So another option you have with SNMP is to add an RMON sensor, which we can do on the same device. So let's go back and add the sensor. We can search for it. Here we got it. And as we see, there's a couple of ports, so we're just going to select some as before. And let's refresh. Now that they turn green, let's have a look at them. And we see what's very nice with the RMON sensor, that it gives you us a couple more metrics than the simple SNMP sensor. So it's very similar to what we saw at the network card sensor.
If you find this video helpful, feel free to like it and consider watching our other videos on our channel. If you still have questions, please contact support@pessler.com. And always feel free to comment for feedback or suggestions for other topics. Thank you.